Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. Honda employs series parallel hybrid systems in their hybrid vehicles. It consists of a generator step-up gear and generator, a drive motor and a drive motor reduction gear, a hydraulic multiplate clutch, an idler gear, a differential, a traction inverter, and hybrid battery. Before exploring the ingenious mechanisms of Honda hybrid system, we will first learn about the three types of hybrid systems and series hybrids. There are three types of hybrid systems: power split, series, and parallel. The power split system is used by Toyota, Ford, Subaru, and Renault. This channel offers videos with detailed explanations of the hybrid systems used by Toyota and Subaru. If you're interested, please check them out. There are links in the description. In a series hybrid, the engine is dedicated solely to driving the generator, while a separate electric motor drives the wheels. The wheels and the engine are not mechanically connected at all. Nissan uses this system. Parallel hybrids use a configuration that adds an electric motor to the traditional engine and transmission setup. Many automakers, especially in Europe, have adopted this system. The terms series and parallel refer to the flow of energy. In series hybrids, energy flows in a straight path from the engine to the generator, inverter, drive motor, and then to the wheels. In parallel hybrids, there are two parallel flows, one from the engine, transmission, and wheels. And the other from the battery, inverter, drive motor, transmission, and wheels. The Honda hybrid system is referred to as a series parallel system because it switches between series and parallel modes depending on the driving conditions. In series hybrid systems, the engine and wheels are not mechanically connected, so the operation of the drive motor and generator is controlled based on driving conditions and hybrid battery charge level, regardless of vehicle speed. When the battery is sufficiently charged, the vehicle can run solely on the drive motor without operating the engine. When driving at a constant speed, the engine operates the generator, which produces electricity to power the drive motor. If the battery charge is low, the system increases power generation to operate the drive motor while charging the battery. If a large amount of power is needed, such as during rapid acceleration, the engine speed is increased to generate more electricity. During deceleration, the drive motor operates as a generator to charge the battery. The resistance generated by the generator acts as braking force to slow down the vehicle. This is referred to as regenerative braking. If the battery becomes fully charged after prolonged use of regenerative braking on a long downhill slope, the generator operates as an electric motor to rotate the inactive engine, consuming electricity. The strength of series hybrids is that the vehicle is driven solely by an electric motor. Similar to battery EVs, it can generate strong low-end torque, delivering powerful acceleration from a standstill. Let's compare a series hybrid vehicle and a parallel hybrid vehicle. The explanation is highly simplified. Please understand in advance. We will consider a vehicle with a maximum torque of 200 Nm. The electric motor generates maximum torque from 0 rpm to low speeds. So, in the series hybrid vehicle, the torque curve is shown in the figure on the left. In the parallel hybrid vehicle, the maximum torque generation speed range of the engine and electric motor are different. So the torque curve is as shown in the figure on the right. We can see that the driving force at startup is greater in series hybrid vehicles, resulting in better drivability. There are also weaknesses. The drive motor and generator are controlled by the traction inverter. The traction inverter converts the DC electricity from the battery into AC electricity to operate the drive motor. Additionally, the traction inverter converts the AC electricity generated by the generator into DC to charge the battery. A series hybrid is equipped with a drive motor and a generator, so it has two inverter circuits as well. During driving, the battery's DC is converted to AC and sent to the drive motor. During power generation, the generator's AC is converted to DC and sent to the battery. Then, what about when the electricity generated by the generator is directly sent to the drive motor? The traction inverter converts the AC generated by the generator into DC, and then it converts the DC back into AC to operate the drive motor. This time, we will compare it with a gasoline engine vehicle. These gasoline engines are operating at a constant speed with a thermal efficiency of 30%. By ignoring the transmission losses, in the gasoline engine vehicle, 30% of the energy in the gasoline is used to drive the wheels. If the efficiency of the inverters are 95% and the efficiency of the drive motor and generator is 90%, then in the series hybrid vehicle, only 22% of the energy in the gasoline is effectively used. Please note, this phenomenon occurs during constant speed driving. In situations where acceleration and deceleration are repeated, the efficiency of gasoline engines drops by about 10-15%. In such situations, the fuel efficiency of gasoline vehicles deteriorates significantly. However, in series hybrid vehicles, the engine operates only within its high efficiency range, resulting in excellent fuel economy. However, this weakness becomes more noticeable during highway driving due to the characteristics of the electric motor, where efficiency decreases at high rotational speed. The Honda hybrid system directly connects the engine to the differential, overcoming the drawbacks of series hybrid systems. Let's take a closer look at the structure. The output from the engine is transmitted to the generator through a step-up gear. A hollow drive motor is mounted coaxially with the generator shaft. The output from the drive motor is transmitted to the differential through a drive motor reduction gear and an idler gear. The system has another output path. The outer shell of the hydraulic multiplate clutch is connected to the engine output shaft, while the clutch hub is connected to the output shaft of the drive motor reduction gear. By activating the hydraulic multiplate clutch, these two shafts are connected. Let's take a look at how the hybrid system operates under various driving conditions. When the battery charge is sufficient, the drive motor is operated by the battery power. During normal driving, the engine operates the generator, and the electricity generated is used to operate the drive motor. These are the operations as a series hybrid. As mentioned earlier, the fuel efficiency of series hybrid systems worsens during highway driving. To prevent this, the Honda hybrid system engages the hydraulic multiplate clutch during highway driving, transmitting the engine output to the differential. This feature significantly improves the highway fuel efficiency of the Honda hybrid system compared to other series hybrids. In summary, the Honda hybrid system has three modes: EV mode, which runs on battery power only; hybrid mode, where the engine generates electricity to power the drive motor; and engine mode, where the vehicle is powered by the engine. It uses the optimal mode depending on the driving conditions. Honda has also introduced a parallel axis hybrid system for models that require higher output. A large diameter drive motor and a small diameter, long length generator are arranged with their axes offset to achieve a package size equivalent to a coaxial layout. This layout allows for individual gear ratios to be set for the drive motor and the generator. This makes it possible to set optimized gear ratios for each component, depending on the model and market. The S+Shift is a simulated 8-speed shifting mechanism that will be equipped in the upcoming Prelude, which is scheduled for release soon. Although the series hybrid system allows for seamless acceleration and deceleration, this feature replicates shifting as if there were an 8-speed transmission. First, we will review the shifting of the step-type automatic transmission using engine sounds and meters. Please note, this engine sound is created using an engine sound simulator and is not from a Prelude. For those interested, there is a link in the description to an engine sound simulator that allows you to create engine sounds based on cylinder configuration, displacement, and other factors. It can be observed that during upshifting, the engine speed drops once before rising again, while during downshifting, it briefly increases. To replicate this, the S+Shift increases the generator's output during simulated upshifting, raising resistance and forcibly reducing the engine speed quickly. During simulated downshifting, the generator is operated as a motor and forcibly increasing the engine speed quickly. Now, in addition to the meters and engine sound, please also observe the operation of the hybrid system. Green represents the motor operation, while blue represents the generator operation. Pay attention to the direction of the flow of electricity. According to Honda engineers, the new direct injection 2.0-liter engine has a wider high-efficiency operating range, minimizing the impact on fuel efficiency even when the engine speed fluctuates like this. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.